continuing with the discussion of momentum flux correction factor beta, the net force acting on the control volume during steady flow is equal to the difference between the rates of outgoing incoming momentum flows. So it is important because everything happens at the inlet or outlet. The example that we just considered has one inlet and one outlet. But as we have mentioned, that it can be more. So if there are more, then in summation of forces, we sum them up. The effects at each inlet, we write down the values at each inlet, we write down the values at each outlet and compute the value that come out of it. And it's a very simple thing. Every day we do it in our algebraic computations. The forces at one inlet and outlet will be written in this form, but if there are several, we can add them up, all of them, and along x coordinates, all terms of this form can be written. If there are 2, 3, 4, we can substitute all of them just in this format. The net force acting on a control volume with only one inlet and outlet, that we have already worked out, and that will turn out to be this one from which the value of the beta can be calculated. If the flow is steady in a situation where there is one inlet and one outlet, then it is shown in the determination by vector addition of the reaction forces on the support caused by change of direction of water. We can see it here. But the fluid is flowing. It's a simple situation. It's coming in from here, going out here, and the flow field situation is smooth. We don't see much turbulence there. And therefore, all we have to do is simple calculations to find out what are the values of beta at inlet and at outlet. So, if we know the values of the V, and in case V1 is equal to V2 or different, their values have to be substituted in the equations that we calculated, and from that we just determine the equations. And in our computations, as we have mentioned, that beta must be taken care of. It is useful to consider beta. Now, if somehow it's not necessary or it eliminates itself, it's a different matter for inlet at outlet, because the fluid flow situation can be different, and therefore it's important that we consider it.